Hi, I'm Vikram and welcome back to A Roll of Film. In today's video, I'm going to review the Nikon FM10. The Nikon FM10 was manufactured from 1995. And to many, this is not a true Nikon in the sense that this camera was actually manufactured by Cosina. Nikon had outsourced the manufacture of this camera to Cosina. Now in 1995, the economies in South Asia and Southeast Asia had begun to recover, and there was a large number of amateur photographers who aspired to own a Nikon. Unfortunately, even at that time, the prices of a Nikon were a little beyond their reach, and therefore Nikon decided to manufacture a camera that would be affordable or would do well in this market. So they outsourced the manufacturing process to Cosina. Now the Nikon FM10 has an aluminium alloy body which you can trace its origin to the Cosina CT1. In fact, the Cosina CT1 was a model for a lot of other cameras. Cosina has this reputation or had this practice of building cameras for other manufacturers too. So the FM10 is basically a stripped down Nikon and having just the bare necessities for a camera. And it has come under a lot of criticism. People say that it is it's a cheap, very cheap version and marketed at people who are brand conscious but not really, more brand conscious than value conscious, in the sense that they're not really interested in the quality, they just wanted the brand name Nikon. So therefore this camera is basically stripped down and offers you just the very basics, all that you need and nothing that you don't need for photography. Now the body is of course aluminium alloy, but the top is very rather plasticky looking, plastically feeling, and the Nikon logo is just sort of embossed, not even embossed, it's just plastered out here, and as you can see in this model it's kind of worn off. So it's not really a very 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 good looking camera, just very basic camera, but it has everything you need and nothing that you don't. And the funny thing is that after it was released and it did well, it started doing well in the Asian market, a lot of European photographers discovered this model, and then a huge demand arose for this model, and therefore Nikon started manufacturing and selling this worldwide. And this became a favorite, firm favorite, especially among beginners, beginning photographers, because it was relatively affordable and it had everything that one needed. So now let's have another look, closer look at this camera. So it has the Nikon F mount, which means that it can take any Nikon lens which has the F mount and which has an AI lens, that is an aperture indexing lens, which means that it can take mostly all the Nikon lenses available in the market today, with a few exceptions of course. It also has a metering system. Now this is a fully manual camera. It is only the metering system that works with a battery. So even if you don't have a battery, or if your battery dies on you, you can still use this camera without the metering system. Now it has a very very simple metering system. It has a center weighted average meter in which 60% of the reading is taken from the center and the balance 40 from the rest of the sensor, rest of the area. And it has on the left hand side of the viewfinder, you generally have three indicators. You have a plus, you have a zero, and you have a minus. So when the green light lights up on the zero, it means you have the correct aperture. If you have a red on the plus, it means that you are overexposing. If you have a green and a red, it means you are one overexposed, one stop overexposed, and similarly for the underexposed. It has shutter speeds starting from B all the way up to 2000, 2, 4, 8, 15, 30, 60, 125, 250, 500, 1000 and 2000. So it has quite a wide range of shutter speeds. You have the shutter speed dial here on top, and you can just shift it around to choose your correct shutter speed. Now this dial has an outer ring, so you just lift the outer ring and you swivel it around. It has a small window here which can show you the aperture setting for the for your exposure meter. You have here it is a mechanical shutter, which means that you don't need a battery to use the shutter, and you have the film advance lever here. The shutter will only work if the film advance lever is advanced, and once you press the shutter, you cannot press it again unless you advance the lever. So which means that you cannot, there's no no danger of any double exposure. However, it has a small lever here. So if you push the lever down and then advance the lever, what happens is that it only cocks the shutter, it doesn't move the film. So you can do multiple exposures using this camera. So I done the mount. You can use Nikon F bayonet mounts, any lens with that, and which has that AI feature. I've covered the exposure meter, which is a very basic, simple exposure meter. And then you have the shutter speeds here. You have the mechanical shutter, and you have the advanced lever. Another interesting thing here is that this advanced lever has a small sort of a protrusion here, which fits right under the shutter. So when the lever, so when you want to use the shutter, you have to sort of pull the lever up like this, slightly out, and then you can put the shutter. If you want to lock the shutter, you just push the lever all the way back, and then you just can't. You can't use. Here it has a small small window here, which you can, from where you can see how many exposures you have left. So very basic camera, but covers everything that you need, and nothing that you don't need. Now in 2006, Nikon decided to concentrate on their digital cameras, and so every film camera is discontinued making film cameras except for the FM10 and the high-end FE. So that says a lot about this camera, that the FM10, that Nikon decided to continue with the FM10 in the time of digital. Unfortunately, last year in 2020, Nikon, for reasons best known to themselves, discontinued the FM10. So the FM10 was the only, one of the only two film cameras that more or less survived in the digital age, which says a lot for this camera. And one thing I forgot to mention is that the focusing, it has a manual focus, there's no automatic focus, and it has a split image and a microprism mode of focusing. Now this is a beautiful camera. I've used it quite a lot. Generally it used to come as a kit with a 35-70mm Nikon lens. I don't have that lens on this. I just use a normal 50mm lens, and I have a 200mm which I use for my wildlife. So this is a beautiful camera, and like I said before, it has everything that you need, nothing that you don't. So before I complete, I'd just like to mention a couple of things more. Number one, of course, you have the hot shoe here for the flash. You have your self timer here. You just pull down this lever and press your shutter, and it'll go up. And when it, once it reaches the top, your shutter will activate your shutter. To activate the exposure meter, you can half press the shutter lever, or there's another button here which you can press down. This will activate the exposure meter and give you the readings. Well, I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, kindly like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you, and look forward to seeing you again.